Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of beautiful sunbeams or sunrays piercing through a forest. This is an update of a tutorial I did a few years ago on an earlier version of Photoshop. I provided this forest background that you can download so you can follow along. Its link is located in my video's description or project files below. Its width is 1920 pixels, its height is 1280 pixels, and its resolution is 72 pixels per inch. If you're using a different photo, make sure its resolution is also 72 pixels per inch to ensure that your result will look similar to mine. Make a copy of the background by pressing Ctrl or Command J. We'll use this copy to separate the sky from the land. For this example, go to Select and Color Range. Select Sample Colors. Check Localize Color Clusters, which obtains a cleaner, more precise selection. I'll keep the fuzziness at approximately 80. A higher amount selects more colors, while a lower amount selects fewer colors. The range slider fine-tunes the areas of your selection. I'll keep it at 100%. Click on the sky to select it. To include more of the sky, press and hold Shift each time you click on more spots of the sky until you see all of the sky in the preview window. Then click OK. Press Q on your keyboard to see your selection as a quick mask. Next, we'll paint out unwanted areas. Open your pencil tool and pencil picker. Make the size 100 pixels, the hardness 100%, and the opacity 100%. Brush over areas of the quick mask that aren't part of the sky and aren't completely opaque. When you're done, revert it into a selection. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. We'll fill the selection with white. To do this, press Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open the Fill window. Open the Contents list and click White. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. Since we now have the shapes that make up the sky on a separate layer, we can trash layer 1. Make it active and press the Delete key on your keyboard or drag it into the trash. Name it Rays. We'll convert it into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively and adjust the effects that we'll be adding to it at any time. To do this, click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Blur, and Radial Blur. Make the amount 100, the blur method Zoom, and the quality Best. Drag the center of the crosshair to a position that's relative to your photo from where you'd like the source of the sun rays to emanate. For this example, I want the sun rays to emanate near the top center of the photo, so I'll place the crosshair point at that position in the preview window. Double-click on an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Click Outer Glow and the Color Box. In the hexadecimal field, type in F8F8D. Make the blend mode screen and the opacity 75%. The technique is softer, the spread is 0%, the size is 1 pixel, and the range is 50%. Change the blend mode to soft light and make a copy of the layer. We're going to make the sun rays of the copy larger, but first, let's zoom out a bit to give us a bit more room. Press Ctrl or Command and the minus key on your keyboard once or twice. Press Ctrl or Command T to open your transform tool. If you see this message, it's just letting us know that the outer glow effect will be temporarily turned off while we use the transform tool. Just click OK or press Enter or Return. Go to the center of the transform's bounding box where you'll see a small icon called the reference point. Drag it to the center of your sunrays. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it out approximately this much. Notice the bounding box got larger from the center of the reference point. To accept it, press Enter or Return. Zoom back in by pressing Ctrl or Command and the plus key on your keyboard once or twice. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 50 pixels. Make the original rays layer active, and again go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. This time blur it 5 pixels. Change its blend mode to soft light. Next, we'll add the sun. Make the top layer active and click the new layer icon to make a new layer above it. To position the sun more accurately, we'll make a temporary composite snapshot of the image. To do this, press Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Go to Filter, Render, and Lens Flare. The brightness is 100% and the lens type is 50 to 300 mm zoom. Drag the flare to the center of the sun rays. Then click OK. Now that we have its position, we can delete the composite snapshot. Make a new layer, and we'll fill it with black. Open the fill window and click black. Change its blend mode to screen and press Ctrl or Command F to repeat your last filter, which was the lens flare. Photoshop remembers the exact position and settings that we chose. Lastly, we'll adjust the color of the light of the sun to match the radio light that's filtering through the trees. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Hue Saturation. Since we want the adjustment layer to affect just the lens flare and not any of the layers under the lens flare, we'll need to make the adjustment layer into a clipping mask. To do this, either click the clipping mask icon or press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac. Check Colorize, and for the hue, type in 37. And 44 for the saturation. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.